So now we are in Fiskars Village. This is the home of the consumer brand company Fiskars. It's an international brand. And this company originated here in this village in 1640 something. Production was here going until I think late 80s. Actually, where my studio is, so here they have been making axes and knives and things like that. Nowadays it's renovated for art studio. This village is quite a historically special place in Finland. There isn't any other place that looks like this really here, the whole country. I've been here with my wife 5 years ago. Before that, we lived in a residency in the countryside, and before that, I had been living in the city. But now this kind of countryside life is somehow feels very good. So I grew up in the city of Espoo. It's a neighboring city to our capital Helsinki. It's kind of a suburban city to Helsinki, and originally I wanted to be a professional soccer player, and until I was 13 that was my only option. But then I realized that I'm actually really talented in drawing, and I started to draw every day and practice soccer every day, and they were going together. But when I was 16, then I realized I'm gonna stop this soccer playing, that I'm not fast enough. I won't be a real top player in the world. So then I decided I'm going to concentrate all my efforts on art. So after high school, I wanted to apply to the Fine Art Academy to study painting, but I for some reason I missed the application deadline. And then I decided that for maybe 1 year I could study something else before applying again. So for fun I applied to the ceramic and glass department at the design school in Helsinki. And I got accepted to the school. And pretty soon I realized that this three-dimensional sculpting, that's more natural for me than painting, two-dimensional work. And after that I haven't really painted a single painting. After graduation from the university, I went to live in working in Canada. In Toronto, I was working in an artist residency for 3 years there doing my art sculpting. And then I had an exhibition in Finland. It was in 2003, Ruby Gallery, and I was chosen the Emerging Artist of the Year. It's quite important art award in Finland. I have a studio also in the old ceramic factory in Helsinki called Arabia. So there has been this art department in the top floor of the ninth floor of the factory since the 30s. And there has been the top Finnish ceramic artists and designers been working there since then. And there I was using the factory glazes, and they needed to be fired high. So if I glaze my work, then I glaze them with the Arabia factory glazes. I've always wanted to combine glass and ceramic. And so I made my first human figure. So I came up with this idea of a girl spitting a glass spit. When I was living in Canada, I had found that there was some artist where glass artists were using this flocking technique on their glass pieces, glass sculptures, and I got kind of interested in this tool. But then it took me until 2012 when I decided I'm gonna buy this flocking tool. And with this flocking, you get this kind of a velvety surface object with nylon fiber. It's an electrostatically transfer. Nylon fiber on the surface of the object. So I bought this tool, and I bought many kind of different colors of fibers. and I was doing tests, but nothing really worked. And then I had this sculpture that I didn't like so much, and I had been painted it black. And then I decided I had this horrible looking yellow nylon fiber, nylon fiber, and I was like, what am I going to do with this? So I put it on the black sculpture, and suddenly this surface became this kind of a vibrant mossy texture on it and look on it. And that took me some time, but then I realized that this is perfect for my figures. They are this kind of a fairy tale troll figures. And at that time I already had moved to Fiskars, and there's a lot of forest here with beautiful old trees, like many hundred year old trees with this incredibly beautiful moss on them. So all this inspired me then to start to make these moss people sculptures.
In my mind, I feel that the moss people, the kids, they are from the future. Living in the future, I don't know exactly what year, but maybe shall we say 100 years from here. And there is there has happened something, and then they are kind of by themselves. They have to take care of themselves. And that's why they're carrying some random object that for us it has no real meaning. But for them it has some, they have made some meaning to those objects. For them it's important. It's some kind of a relic from ancient times that is our time, but Asian for them.
So here I'm working on a sculpture of a girl. It's gonna be a moss girl feeding a two-headed rabbit. So there is an example of this work in the exhibition actually. This is another version. So I put in like the finishing touch. Now this head part has to dry a little bit. I think it's now enough dry, and I'm gonna put some more clay here. Let it dry a little bit, and then I put the hair, and I start to finish the eyes and all that, the face. And then it's gonna dry, and then fire, and then that's the last thing. I'm gonna put the nylon fiber blocking on this object. Takes me about maybe a month to finish a sculpture.
Yeah.